The most important grip of all is the forehand grip, used like this. It's a very strong grip, and we use this for power cuts. The second grip is the backhand or reverse grip, where the blade is held with the edge towards us. We use this very rarely. It's used mainly for cutting string, where we want to ensure that the danger, the edge, is towards us, because we are the operator, we're the person holding the blade and have the greatest control. The next most important grip is the chest lever grip, with the edge pointing towards the knuckle of our hand and our thumb on the flat of the blade in support. This is a very useful and very powerful grip, which is used in a unique way. We take the blade across our chest so that the back of the blade is towards our chest, edge forwards. And now we can cut with great force, but lots of control. A good way to show you how to use the knife is to make something that we have to do on a regular basis. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make two tent pegs. We often have to make pegs. Maybe we arrive at a campsite and the ground is soft, too soft for the small pegs that came with our tent, or maybe we're just carrying a tarp and we decide that we want to peg to the ground. Either way, this is how we can go about it. I'm going to show you how to put a point on the stick with just a few easy cuts. To make the points, I'm using the forehand grip, which gives a lot of power. I can put my whole body behind the cut. Put a point on both ends of the stick. And what I'll do now is I'll use my knife to give me a measurement so I can find out roughly where the middle is. And now I'm going to cut through the middle of the stick to give a chamfered end that can be driven with an axe. The chest lever grip gives tremendous control combined with a lot of power, and because it's close to your eyes you can see very clearly what you're achieving. It's also a very safe grip because the knife doesn't fly all over the place. And now we can just snap that there and just trim off the top. There we go, two pegs ready to be driven into the ground. This is a temporary tent peg, but you can easily turn this into a permanent tent peg with a little bit more carving and the use of the fire. I'm just shaving the point of the blade to a more of a pencil shape, more bullet shaped end, which is more durable than the temporary peg. A bit neater. I'll remove some of the bark as well. Pegs like this are excellent. When they're dry, they're very light, they're strong, they do the job beautifully. And what's really nice is they're biodegradable. So should you forget one, and let's face it, people forget tent pegs the whole time, they just decay and go back to nature. I don't want the point though to be too fine, so I'm going to make that a little bit more blunt so that it's stronger for driving into the ground. Like that.